क्लास 9 बायोलॉजी थर्ड चैप्टर टिश्यूज प्लांट एंड एनिमल टिश्यूज। गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे अगेन वी विल कंटिन्यू द सेम चैप्टर एनिमल टिश्यू विद देयर थर्ड एंड फोर्थ टाइप्स। So the third and fourth types are muscle tissue and the nervous tissue. First of all, today we will discuss in detail about the muscle tissue. Dear student, muscle possesses a special characteristics, that is contraction and relaxation. So due to the nature of contraction and relaxation, we can move our body parts as well as we can locomote from one position to the another position with the help of bones. So if we have movements, it is the result of joint action of muscles along with bones. So whatever the movements we have, we can say that it is the result of the muscles we have. So today we'll discuss muscle tissue. Muscle tissue forms the muscles of the body. Muscles can contract and relax, thus they help the body in its movement. Now come to the types of muscle. There are three types of muscles: striated, also known as skeletal, striped or voluntary muscles. Second, unstriated is also known as smooth, unstriped or involuntary muscles. And third, heart or cardiac muscles. So these are the three types of muscles. First of all, striated muscle is also known as voluntary muscles because these are under the control of one's will. Means according to our will, which we can move striated muscles. These muscles possess nucleus. These muscles possess nucleus and have alternate dark and white band. So striated muscles are also known as striped muscles, also known as striped muscles, because these have alternate dark white bands. Due to the action in these dark and white band, muscles either can contract or relax. When all the dark band slide to each other, a muscle contract in size and then relax again. Due to the sliding towards each other, it can contract and then relax. Thus it provides movement to our body. They constitutes about 50% of the total body weight. Means whatever the body we have, it constitutes striated muscle constitutes about 50%. These muscles are especially found in the arms, legs, face and neck. That's why we can move our hands, we can move our legs, we can move our lower jaws and in the neck region. Means just do one activity, this activity. If you are able to move any body parts according to your wish in that location, stated or voluntary muscles are present. Now come to the unstated. These muscles are not under the control of one's will, so also known as involuntary. Clear? These are also again known as smooth muscles. Smooth muscles because these are smooth in outline. They do not have alternate dark and white vein. But one thing is differ from the striae. These do not have nucleus. Nucleus is absent in unstriated muscle. Clear? Found. These are found in the intestinal passages, iris of the eye, skin, lining of blood vessels, urinary bladder, uterus. Means in these parts we do not have any control for their movements, thus it is involuntary in action. Understood all of you? Now come to the very special type, third type, that is cardiac muscle. One thing, the structure of cardiac muscle is almost striated, but the function is involuntary because one cannot stop the beating of the heart, or one cannot initiate the beating of the heart if heart stop beating, because cardiac muscle is involuntary in action. So these cardiac muscles again contain nucleus. And these have fibers. These fibers are known as myofibrils. The fibrous structure in the cardiac muscle is called myofibrils, and having intercalated discs. These are the intercalated disc. Clear? This muscle is specially found in our human heart. So human heart contain only cardiac muscles. Clear all of you? Now come to last type of animal tissue, that is nervous tissue. Nervous tissue do not have any branches. These nervous tissue are meant for the transmission of impulse or signals are the electrical activity that takes place in your body. Means if you are able to feel the changes in your surrounding, that is due to the transmission of impulse by the nervous tissue. The nervous tissue or nervous system consists of a structure called neurons. So neurons are the structural and functional unit of the nervous system or nervous tissue. Once more, neurons are the structural and functional unit of the nervous system or nervous tissue. A neuron consists of three parts. First one is cytone, axon, and the axon in. A cytone, also known as perikaryon or cell body, consist of a nucleus. Cells, granules, the granular structure that are present in the cytoplasms of cyton is called Nissl's granules, and small protoplasmic structures known as dendrites. Once more, a neuron consists of cyton, also known as perikaryon or cell body that contains centrally located nucleus, Nissl's granules, and a small protoplasmic extension known as dendrites. This cyton also contain one long protoplasmic extension called axons. So axons are the long protoplasmic extension which terminate into knob-like structure. This knob-like structure is known as axon. A neuron consists of cyton, axon, and the axon end. This axon, when transmit impulse from the dendrite cyton to the axon end, these do not transmit impulse to the parallel axon because these are insulated by structures called insulators or act as insulator, which consist of neurolemma cells, nucleus, myelin sheath, and the nodes of RAN wire. So all these act as insulator that appears white in color because myelin sheath is white. This structure prevents the transmission of impulse from one axon to the another axon directly. Once more, these cytons or nervous tissue help in the transmission of impulse. Understood all of you? Okay, have a good day.